Asparga, le Pasti Scolicidum. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to another one of our shows. Thank you for coming, and please, for your own sake, switch off your mobiles. We hope you really enjoy your time traveling with us on our imaginative journey that we have written ourselves. Now come to our castles aboard.
The scene is set in Buncrana, which means Bunnahoin, the mouth of the River Crana down by the stone jug. All the children come here to play, and villagers to walk and talk, and wait on the herring to come ashore. The fishermen would cart them up Gobbock's Lane, now known as Castle Avenue, and it was a joy to hear the fishermen on the street calling,
"Fresh herring! Fresh herring! And mackerel too! Fresh herring! Fresh herring! And mackerel too!"
Morning, Bridget. How's the lungs today?
Ach, I'm grand. So if I try anything else, would it do anything about it? Nah, you wouldn't. Give me two of them herring for me and the man.
No bother. You're crabbing today, Bridget.
Do you think so, son?
Ah, I'll say nothing. I'm feeling you today, Bridget.
Today, Nora, a villager and a regular walker on that beach, sits on her rock of dreams and shares her stories with the locals. Hers is one of friendship, courtship, and loyalty to her family and friends. A life of doing and giving, a life full of golden dreams and golden castles. Sha, Cash Lenore.
Come to the park, dears, come see us play.
Egypt, and I'm kelp working, and you're down there clowning about. of gold to be true. Cause sometimes I come down here and I stare. And I can see the seahorses out there. I see the strangest things. I see shapes like angels, and I hear them sing. I look out there by the rocks, and I see dancing fairies in floral frocks. I run and I dance with them a lot, and I say out loud, "This is my Camelot." Not that I know what that means, Nora. Camelot? But God knows that sounds real swanky. Oh, I love you, Nora, more than her ma's scone bread and shawl cakes and blackberry jam. See you, Nora. Bye!
Bye!
I want to be a somebody, a smart one, like you, Nora. But all the king's horses, and all the king's men, and all the castle of gold could not help me. I have no head on me. Everyone says that. But I come down here, I'm free! No work, simple! No floors, dishes, pots, messes, go, go, go! So down here is gold to me. Down here are sandcastles that I can build. Because I love doing it. Is that called diddling?
My dad says it's called Dawson.
Well, God bless you. Now run along, Hunter. Go on.
I love you, Nora. As Nora Negarty looked back to those carefree times of her childhood, different kinds of memories come back to haunt her. The old boat that her father made out of potato sacks and flour bags from Swan's Mill at the foot of the town. The fun young Seamus McFadden and herself had playing for hours, riding make-believe waves, floating as though they were mid-sea, gliding in their make-believe curra. So, so carefree.
Seamus!
What? Quit the pushing.
You're not listening to me.
What do you want? You're a torture.
Imagine if this could be our own vessel. It would take us out to the sea.
Oh, imagine the way she must
come on.
We'll head for the castles of ore. Out there, by the rocks.
We'll take off barnacles tonight like the fishermen.
Come on, let's do it.
Right, here's the oars.
Got them.
We're off!
We're
away!
Woo!
Up and up!
Watch out for that big wave coming, Seamus! Ah! Ah! I'm soaked and dried and destroyed! What will we do?
Ah! Fry! Up! We're only playing, and you overdo it all the time, Nora. You're cat. And it's getting late, and I'll be looking for it. And so will you, Nora. Come on.
Ah, shouldn't do it with you, Gony. Spoiled sport, spoiled sport.
I remember that glorious day with Seamus just after school, dreaming the afternoon away as to where and how we would both end up. And me so proud of all the learning I'd done. I'm trying to teach you my way, because I could only see it my way.
Seamus, come here! Do you have castles of ore with dreams galore?
Ah, my castle's up in the air. Rubbish castles of despair. Now look at you, Amia. I hate that rhyme thing. I hate it.
Oh, Seamus, I love it. It's great to help you up remembering things. Seamus, go and watch me now. Go and watch me. Y'all can see it from my mouth. Butter's white and cream, Michelle. That's the main town of Cork. The largest county in Ireland. It's easy like that, Seamus.
Nora, you're a stew. A smart one. And me, well, I'm gonna be a master foreman, brick by brick. Someday, but not around here. It's America, I fear.
Not at all, Seamus. I'll study hard, we'll be fine. I'll be a teacher in no time. Watch, listen to me, Seamus.
The Armagh apples, a delight. Potato apple bread, a wonderful sight. Cheer from Galway, with sugar so sweet. The Galway show, you'll be on your feet. Kerrygold butter, help the players play it well. Best fair players, the truth to tell. Dublin, the capital, so far away. Beautiful Killiney and Dublin Bay, Blackrock Hoth and Bitterstown too. Liberties and Donabate, to name a few. Limerick, a lady, and that's towns enough. Adair, Abbeyfield, Newcastle and Bruff.
Enough's enough, Nora. We must go. Listen, Nora, you can rhyme all day. That won't take home a working man's pay. I know my destination and call. Sadly, it's not here in my Donegal.
Get that out of your head! You're not going, you're staying here for me instead!
Come on, Seamus! Tia! We're here to work! Listen, I know the feeling to be sad and so lonely too. But it's worse not to have the dollar. The dollar, sonny boy, is your best friend.
I know the feeling to be sad and so lonely, wishing your true love was near. But I'm appealing, don't think of her only. You won't find the answer right here. No, you won't find the answer right here.
Come on!
Break it up, guys, break it up. Come on, Donegal. No point in moping. Sentimental Paddy or Seamus or John Joe Shackleshay. Just move it.
We gotta build her up. Brick by brick. Man up. Come on, it's not forever, Seamus boy. Nothing is, no nothing ever is.
Come on, guys.
So Nora pleaded, but Seamus had his mind made up and wanted so much for her to go with him. Nora could not leave. Aging parents that depended on her made her mind up. And it was with a heavy heart that she bade farewell to her childhood and lifelong friend, Seamus.
I'm